Welcome, friends. Welcome back to the kitchen. Welcome back to Cocktails After Dark. Today, we're going to do another cocktail out of this book, The Old Waldorf Bar Days, published in 1931 at the height of Prohibition, published in New York. It represents recipes that pre-Prohibition had been served at the Old Waldorf Bar in New York City. A cocktail book that I love to hate because it's compiled from a bunch of different recipes written by different bartenders. And so it's very inconsistent in its language. It's very inconsistent in its use of measurements. It's very inconsistent in the way that it tells you to build the cocktails. So you have to sort of really pick through the information and try to figure out what they were getting at, which can be a little bit difficult. Today we're going to do a cocktail called the Brut, or Brew, or Brut, straight up Brut, if you read the little story that goes with the cocktail. And I've chosen this cocktail because it uses this, Calisaya. And Calisaya is essentially a dead cocktail ingredient. This is the only company that I can find that still makes it. Very low production. It is a bitter liqueur whose main component is cinchona bark, or quinine, and bitter orange peels. So very bitter. Next ingredient, it asks for French vermouth. I'm going to use this Bianco, even though it is a little bit sweeter than French vermouth, because I like it. It's the right vermouth for me. Next in, a couple of dashes of orange bitters. I'm making two cocktails, so four dashes. And then a dash of absinthe. So again, I'm doing two cocktails, two dashes. Next, we're going to ice the tin. The only thing that this recipe says about building this recipe is frappe. Now, I've done cocktails out of this book in the past, and where people have seen frappe, they have left comments saying, I did it wrong, you're supposed to serve it over crushed ice. Which, in the context of 2020, you would be correct. This is 1930, and some of these recipes go back to the 1800s. In the context of this book, frappe simply means to shake with ice. There are a couple of recipes in here that give you an indication of how that's correct. They say frappe and then strain and serve, and other ones say serve frappe. So I'm assuming that where it says frappe, it just means to shake and shake hard. And that's kind of what it says in the back here in some of the instructions. Frappe just means to shake. If it meant to be served frappe, it would say serve frappe. So let's give this a shake. Okay, I've got two Nick and Noras chilled down and ready to go. And we will double strain. So this is the Brut cocktail.
The Brut cocktail.
Brut.
Hi, friends. Hi, Glen.
So let's give it a taste and see what happens. Let's try it first and then we'll talk about it. Oh, that was no good.
Let's try that again.
Oh.
Apparently it's very dense because you don't get a ting sound when you...
It is very dense, yeah. Wow.
It smells like it has a really sweet smell to it.
It does, but it's not sweet at
No.
all. Well, I mean, Brut means it's a dry cocktail, or raw, if you want to go for the actual. Now, I used Bianco, a semi-sweet white vermouth instead of a dry French vermouth, because I really like that one.
It's almost licorice-y.
Well, yes, there is a touch in there.
Okay, so that would explain that. I'm like, trying, I'm drinking it going, why is it, what is this flavor? I'm thinking really hard. Did you see that? Thinking really hard part?
There is some absinthe in it.
Okay.
A touch of absinthe.
Yeah.
So this is Calisaya. Again, another dead ingredient. This was really hard to get my hands on. There is only one manufacturer that I know of left, and that's this one. And they don't make it in really large quantities. This is March 2021 when we're filming this. This has been sitting on a warehouse.
Since 2015.
So very low volume, very low demand for that particular ingredient.
Although maybe this will change.
Maybe.
No particular scent to it. So as soon as it goes in your mouth, you get that whoosh of that alcohol.
Yeah.
Like that, not the harsh, but just the, that way it evaporates in your mouth.
It sticks around. It's kind of sweet.
That would help explain, that would also explain that denseness of the.
The denseness. So cinchona bark and bitter orange peel. And it's a liqueur. So it's heavy on the sugar and it's made with other botanicals in a, neutral grain spirit.
I think over a piece of ice to just little give it a little chill yeah. would be
on its own. It would be great. Mm-hmm. In this, it's I really like this. Now I've also noticed that Calisaya shows up in places like this 1892 cocktail book, where it's only used as a dash, and it's used in the place of orange bitters.
Okay.
Which I think is interesting that there's orange bitters in this cocktail.
They're going all out.
Mm-hmm. I like this. I think this is good. I like the Calisaya. So we're going to do a bunch of Calisaya videos since I've got that bottle now. And it's one of these things that shows up over and over and over in these old cocktail books.
That's really quite lovely.
It is nice. It is very nice. Thanks for stopping by. See you again soon.